Hi everyone, my name's Sunny and welcome to my maths adventure. In this video, I'll be talking about how many years you will need to complete your A-level maths and further maths qualification. Maths and further maths is a natural A-level combination to actually take if you enjoy and excel in mathematics. However, the study options available are sometimes confusing due to there being no set way to teach both A-levels at school or college. Traditionally, students will do 3 to 4 A-levels over 2 years. However, some A-levels can be condensed into 1 year, which enables students to gain the full qualification in 1 year rather than 2. For some students, studying A-levels in 1 year is the only option available. This could be because they didn't get the grade they wanted and therefore actually had to retake their exams the following year. So studying A-level maths and further maths again in a condensed 1 year period makes sense, not only because of exams occurring only once a year, but also because they studied A-levels before and they've built a strong foundation in those subjects beforehand. However, for students who don't have the experience with A-level maths and further maths, the 1 year option isn't the only way, nor the best way. That's because doing both A-levels, the full A-level, in 1 year is nearly impossible because of the amount of work, time, and dedication you will need to succeed. But that doesn't mean it can't be done. It's just going to be a huge challenge. That's two full A-levels, A-level maths and A-level further maths in 1 year. There are alternatives. I've done some research into some schools and colleges. I found that there are generally 3 standard ways to study A-level maths and further maths together over 2 years, in addition to 1 or 2 other A-levels as well. One of the options is to do the whole A-level maths qualification in the first year and then do the whole A-level further maths qualification in the second year. Now, this is an intense and super hardcore option. I've rarely seen this teaching format being offered. However, there are some further education establishments that do teach this way. Do take note though, if you do select this option, you will require lots of determination, commitment, and mathematical aptitude to succeed. The second option is more geared towards students who studied A-level maths in the first year and then discovered that they really enjoyed it and they want to take their studies further by taking up further maths. Therefore, the second option is doing the whole A-level further maths qualification in the second year alongside the second year of their normal A-level maths qualification. Now, this is a challenging option also, because not only do you have to complete your normal A-level maths in the second year, but you have to do the whole A-level further maths qualification in the second year as well. Now, this is an intense option. This is also a hardcore option, but I know that there are some schools and colleges that normally offer this option. The third option is to do both A-levels over the standard 2 years. You'll do the first year maths and further maths in the first year, and then you do the second year maths and further maths in the second year. This sounds like an easier option because there's no pressure to complete one A-level in 1 year, which usually takes 2 years. However, what you need to be aware of is how your school or college will structure the course. For example, the first chapter in any further maths textbook is generally complex numbers. Before you can really appreciate complex numbers, you need to understand subjects like quadratics, roots of polynomials, the factor theorem, rationalizing surds, the conjugate of an expression, and be able to use core skills like completing the square. If you haven't studied these topics in your normal A-level maths before you start, then you will find complex numbers a little bit challenging. It's best to talk to your school or college beforehand to see if they offer this option and perhaps ask to see their study plan. That way you can see if there's a clear approach that links the two A-levels together into like one comprehensive study plan. Now, for some students, especially mature students, there is a third way. That is studying A-level maths and further maths over 3 years rather than the standard 2 or even 1. This will, of course, be dependent on things like if you have time to study over 3 years, what your study goals are, if you're planning to get into higher education at the end of your studies. For me, I was in a rush because I was impatient about starting my mathematics degree. However, after a while, I realized that I just didn't want to be good at maths. I wanted to understand what I was doing. This element of understanding and applying what you learn in mathematics can't be rushed and does take experience and time. So that's why I've decided to do A-level maths and further maths over 3 years rather than the standard 2 years. So if you're a student who doesn't have any concrete plans just yet, or you're just enjoying both courses and in no rush, then the 3 year option is an excellent choice. So is it possible to do A-level maths and further maths in 2 years or even 1 year? Yes, it is. However, life isn't an acceleration, it's a revelation. So let the beauty of mathematics reveal itself to you, rather having to force yourself into some sort of arbitrary time frame to finish the two subjects. Enjoy the journey, not the destination.